Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we will take a closer look at the inspector and different settings related to your content clips on the timeline. On the top right, where you can easily find the inspector, you can see the exact time. By dragging the mouse, you can change the value. Of course, you can also do it the old school way and enter the new values manually by using the keyboard. There are different ways you can do this. 300 would translate to 3 seconds, for example. So right at the end, you have the frames and then the seconds. So if I enter 520, the clip would go to 5 seconds and 20 frames. Of course, this input method also depends on the frames per second setting on the timeline you're using. We have 60 FPS in our case. Let me just quickly show you that we can go up to 60 frames here. Option number two would be using addition or subtraction. So I could enter plus 200 and the locator would jump 2 seconds. The same is true for minus minus. You can do the same on the left when dealing with the timeline directly. Just to show you it's true, let's do it once more. Duration influences the length of a clip. So entering 200 here would mean that my clip suddenly gets shortened to just 2 seconds on the timeline. And of course, using your mouse still works for that purpose as well. I just entered 1000 to jump back to 10 seconds. Next, let's look at play modes. The standard mode is lock to time. This means that as long as my timeline is set to play, the clip will also play. Option number two would be free play once, which means that if the locator is within the clip container, it will get played once. Once it has been played, it will pause. Next in line is free loop, which will loop a clip continuously. As long as the locator is within the clip container, the clip will be looped, even if we have hit a pause locator on the timeline. We should now look at in-point and out-point options. Here we can define different in- and out-points for our clip. Let's get the in-point to 2 seconds and the out-point to 4 seconds. As you can see, only the time between 2 and 4 seconds gets played. You can also combine it with free loop, and as you can see now, the clip loops, but only from the 2 to 4 seconds bit. Below this, you can find speed, which allows you to change the playback speed. So if I enter 2, it will play with twice the speed. If I enter 4, it will be 4 times the speed. This also works for slowing things down. So 0.5 will show the clip at half speed. Last but not least is show endpoints. This shows you the exact frames of the selected endpoint. So no video playback, but a freeze frame. Thank you for watching this Pixera tutorial. Why not subscribe to our YouTube channel?